A quick update. I've started DPI with my students. It's going well, and I am documenting solid growth in my students' math skills. However, I know that math fluency is essential in mathematics, and my kids seem to retrieve math facts very slowly. What are some strategies I can use to help them?
Well, Mr. Flores, that's what we're going to talk about in this module. Welcome to Module 5, where we're going to talk about different instructional strategies that should be embedded within the instructional platform and used within intervention adaptations. And we're going to focus a lot on fluency building, but we're not just going to focus on that, we're also going to focus on problem solving and motivation. So our three parts to this module, first we're going to focus on building fact fluency, then we're going to talk about effective problem solving instruction, and finally we're going to talk about the importance of embedding a motivational component within intensive intervention. So there's lots of fun activities to do within this module. First, you're going to do some activities where you look at a video of a flashcard routine and comment about that. We'll think about implementing incremental rehearsal, and you will design one fact fluency activity, either taped problems or cover, copy, compare. And then you'll have a discussion board where you share some other activities with your colleagues. In part two, we're going to do some activities that think all about problem solving. So why keywords are not helpful to use within problem solving. And then you'll identify the different schemas in additive problems and multiplicative problems and share a word problem attack strategy. And then finally, in part three, you're going to think about different motivational systems that are used within intervention, and then you're going to share some helpful motivational tools. So as we've been working through this entire course, we've been thinking about what does effective instruction look like for students with learning difficulties. And the six components that we're focusing on are using explicit instruction, the use of multiple representations, and strong, concise language. And we talked about all of those in Module 4. In this module, we're focusing on strategies that should be embedded within intensive intervention. And those strategies include fluency building, problem-solving instruction, and a motivational component. So we do have a reading for this module. This reading deals with problem solving, and it's actually not an article. It's one of the IES practice guides, and it has a really good recommendations on how to teach problem solving, and all the recommendations are evidence-based. So once you get into the IES practice guide, you'll see a page with recommendations like this, and these are the five evidence-based recommendations related to teaching problem solving in the elementary and middle school grades. And so I think it's a good reading to do before we get to part two of this module, because it'll really frame a lot of the things that we talk about within the problem solving instruction part of this module. And then by the end, after we do the fluency and the problem solving and talk about the motivational component, you'll do a classroom application where you're going to identify the different types of word problems that your students see on high-stakes assessments, and you're going to figure out what would be a good attack strategy related to those word problems, and what schemas would you need to teach to help students understand how to set up and solve those problems. So we're so excited you're here with us to start Module 5. Let's go ahead and get started.